Okay, we have seen these three steps for writing chemical equations and how we combine these three steps into a single step. Now we move ahead to the next step, that is step 4. Step 4 is balancing the chemical equation. Now what does this mean? This means that the number of atoms of each element on the left hand side must be equal to the number of atoms of each element on the right hand side. Now I'll show you with the help of an example. Suppose we have this reaction over here. In this reaction we have two atoms of hydrogen over here, two atoms of oxygen over here, but on the right hand side we have two atoms of hydrogen but only one atom of oxygen. So this is not balanced because on the left hand side we have two atoms of oxygen but on the right hand side we have only one atom of oxygen. Hydrogen atoms are balanced on both sides because here also there are two atoms and here also there are two atoms, but oxygen, number of oxygen atoms, they are not balanced. Here there are two atoms and here there is only one atom. Similarly, in this reaction also, magnesium, there is only one atom. Here also magnesium has one atom, so that is balanced. But oxygen here has two atoms, but here oxygen has only one atom. So these reactions, they are not balanced reactions. So step 4 is about balancing these reactions, means making the number of atoms of each element on the left hand side equal to the number of each element on the right hand side. So that is our step 4, and that is what we have to go through, and we shall go through that in a subsequent video. But before that we have to just understand that there are two important things that we have to note. That is, while balancing a chemical equation, we cannot change the molecular formula of the compound, okay? And we can only add some numbers to the left of each element, each reactant or product, in order to balance the equation. We'll come over in a next video to understand what this actually means through some examples. So meet you very soon.